Thank you for joining this video about stealing parts of large language models. Many of the top large language models today, such as GPT-4, Claude 3, and Gemini, are closed source, so a lot about the inner workings of these models is not known to the public. One justification for this is usually the competitive landscape, since companies are investing a lot of money and effort to create these models. And another justification is security, since it is easier to attack models when more information is available. In this video, we study a recent research paper with authors from Google DeepMind, titled Stealing Part of a Production Language Model, which presents a model stealing attack that extracts internal information from black box language models, and the attack is performed via a standard API access, where the attacker is using the API to get internal data about the model behind the API. Specifically, the internal data being stolen is the embedding projection layer, the last layer of the model, and the researchers estimate that it would cost under $2,000 in queries to retrieve the embedding projection layer of GPT 3.5 Turbo. Before diving into the attack details, let's first learn more about when the attack is possible. So, who is the target for the attack presented in the paper? The answer is production language models that are accessible via APIs that expose log probabilities or a logit bias. By log probabilities, the meaning is that we do not just get a generated token, but rather a list of tokens with their log probabilities. So we can learn which are the most possible tokens and how likely each one of them to be the next one. And by logit bias, the meaning is that we can impact the probabilities of tokens we wish to control, to impact the chances of them being the next token. For example, we can exclude a certain token from the output by pushing down its probability to be chosen using a significant bias. These requirements in practice include multiple OpenAI models, including GPT-4 and also Google's PaLM-2. And the researchers have successfully used this attack in order to extract the entire embeddings projection layer for two OpenAI language models, and also to discover the hidden dimension of GPT 3.5 Turbo. And as we mentioned earlier, they could have extracted the entire embedding projection layer of GPT 3.5 Turbo by extending the attack, with less than $2,000 in API queries. It is worth mentioning that by now OpenAI and Google already added mitigations for this attack, since the attack was shared with them prior to publishing the paper. Let's now start to dive into the attack details, starting with the most simple case of recovering the hidden dimension size only. And for start, we have an assumption that the API exposes full logits, meaning that we get from the API the logits of all tokens in the model vocabulary. This is a tough requirement, since in practice the APIs provide just the top log probabilities and not all of the logits, but we'll see later that this requirement is removed. To understand how this is possible, let's first recall what happens in the embedding projection layer. In the following box we have a transformer model, for example, and when we feed it with a prompt, the model processes the prompt via all of the transformer layers until we reach the final embedding projection layer. The input for the embedding projection layer is a vector of hidden states in the size of the hidden dimension, where in the simple example here the size is 4, and the embedding projection layer should project this vector to the tokens in the vocabulary. We do that using a matrix multiplication, where here we simply assume we only have 8 possible tokens in the vocabulary, so the matrix is of size 8 by 4, and so after this multiplication we get a logit for each of the tokens in the vocabulary. A key observation in our example is that the matrix of the embedding projection layer has a rank of at most 4, which is the hidden dimension size, since the rank cannot be larger than the number of columns. And this is the case since the vocabulary size is larger than the hidden dimension size, and this assumption is correct for real models as well. If a matrix has a rank of 4, then it means that each of the 8 rows of the matrix can be written as a linear combination of some 4 vectors. Okay, but how can we use that knowledge in order to discover the hidden dimension size? The answer is based on SVD, which stands for Singular Value Decomposition. We randomize n prompts, and we invoke a LLM that provides a logit vector for each of the prompts. With the result logics, we construct a matrix Q, so each row is the logit vectors for a certain input prompt. Now, if we take a large enough n, we can almost be certain that it is larger than h, the hidden dimension we want to discover. However, the dimensionality is still not larger than H, since these logit vectors are obtained by a matrix multiplication with the embedding projection matrix. The next step is to calculate the rank of the matrix Q, which gives us the estimation for the hidden dimension size. In practice, it gives us an upper bound for the hidden dimension, but the researcher mentioned it is very unlikely that it will be lower if we take a large enough n. And this assumption is fine, as we'll see soon with the results. Before moving on, if you're getting value from this content, then please consider to subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. We also send 1-minute read summaries by mail about the papers we review here. You may find the link to join in the description of this video. Let's now move on to see how we can not only discover the hidden dimension size but also the actual weights of the embedding projection layer. The answer is short, and here as well is based on SVD. With SVD, we can rewrite the matrix Q that we've built from the logits return from the model as a multiplication of 3 matrices. And the researchers found out that U sigma is actually the embedding projection matrix up to a rotation. In the following table from the paper, we can see how close the approximations are. Where for the hidden dimension size, the attack extracts the correct value for the evaluated models almost precisely. And in the right column, we can see the error of the extracted weights after a search for the best rotation of the extracted matrix. For reference, this error is 100 to 500 smaller than for a random guess. Okay, until now we've made a significant assumption that we can get a logit vector for each prompt, but in reality we do not get it. What we do get instead are the log probabilities of the most likely tokens. In order to use the attack we just saw, what we need to show is that given an API that returns the top log probabilities, we can recover the full logit vector. Say that we get the top 5 log probabilities, and that we can add the logit bias to the API query. First, we call the API with a large logit bias for 4 tokens only. The bias is large enough so that these 4 tokens will be part of the top 5 log probabilities. The 5th log probability in the top 5 is used as a common reference between the bias tokens. We'll see what it means in a moment. Second, we want to estimate the logit values for the 4 bias tokens. To understand how, we need a bit of math from the paper. Here we see the log probability for some bias token I. The y on the left is the log probability, and it equals to z, which is the logit, plus b, which is the bias we added, and another component that is dependent on the bias. Now, if we take the log probability of the reference not bias tokens marked with yr, and subtract from it the log probability of a bias token and the bias b, the log component is removed, and we remain with some value for the difference between the logits of the reference token and the bias token. Now, if we replace the reference token logit with 0 or other constant value, we get an approximation for the logits. An important observation for that approximation is that the original difference between the logits is preserved, since we use the same reference token logit value. The third step is to repeat that each time for different 4 tokens, until we get the logits of all tokens. Then, the fourth step is to use the same attack as we covered before when the full logit vector is available. And this attack works quite well, as we can see in the following table from the paper, where a few black box models from OpenAI were attacked using that method. Starting with extracting only the hidden dimension, the researchers were able to obtain the precise hidden dimensions of all of these models, as they have confirmed with OpenAI, but they do not disclose the numbers for GPT-3.5 Turbo. They also share the cost of running the attack, which is not significant. On the right, we can see the error when extracting the weight matrix and the cost for doing that, which is still not very significant. The attack was not executed on all of the models to preserve the security of the weights, and by now defenses have been placed against this attack. Another table from the paper shows comparison between different attack methods where we only cover the first one, which achieves the best results in the lowest cost. However, in the other methods, the researchers show how the attack is possible when there is only one log probability in the API result, or none at all, just with lower precision and higher cost. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers.